Let's go. Let's go, love. April 2nd, 1939. The stars is in line. Divine intervention had its own intention. Birthed the gift in his DC kit. He sung heavenly. Good values and all. And his father was in the ministry. God fearing man with a mother that's so beautiful. The angels would serve her. What's her name? It's Alberta. This little boy quickly became a man. From blowing in his father's church to making his own band. Caught a moon glow. Sensational with his vocals that drove the ladies crazy. Panties got thrown at his shows, but he was far from happy. He wore a smile just to hide it behind them doors. Him and his father constantly colliding. His blessings, young and struggling with pressures. That the fact that his pops was a cross-dresser, but he still loved him. You know the bond between the son and father that only pushed him and forced him to sing harder. His main man, Harvey Fuqua, gassed up his car, believed the sound, and took him down to Motown, y'all. That's where it all happened. Success in the palm of his hand, but unfortunate, the fame wasn't enough. He wanted more out of life, took it further, and found himself a white, pretty Anna Gordy. She made his time sit still. She was the cousin of Barry G, the founder of Hitsville. Please pay attention, because the story against hell, shit's real. Tribes and tribulations some facing. You gotta play the cards you dealt. Ain't no telling what life deals that will cause you to have night chills. Enough to keep a nigga bothered, especially when the negative spark's coming from your father. And drugs came into play. Now wouldn't you know, there goes another happy home down the drain. That nightlife had him speeding through hell, scarred by the death of Tammy Terrell. Couldn't believe it, he spiraled downhill, secluding himself from the music and the press. He was sick and really getting depressed. Time passed, so we bounced back on track, new and improved. Even got himself a new wife too. Everything is on the up and up. Got his act together, spiritually cleansed. You can see the glow up on his fella. Try to make amends with his father, but the hatred is too strong. Revolver in his palm, the warning that death was close. His mother screaming out, honey, don't do it. One shot to the chest made Marvin lose fluids. April 1st, he died on the spot. The scene was so horrific, how a father could kill his own son. The vines wicked.